students, welcome to our SST classroom. Now students, today we are going to learn new lesson, that is lesson number 13, human resources. Right? So are you ready? Now students, you have read about the many resources of India. Right? By resources, we mean the wealth and possession that our country has naturally. Okay? So if we'll talk about the resources, nature has given us a rich stores of natural resources, right? Water, air, soil, forest, mineral and livestock are the nature's gift to us, right students? Students, but these gifts in themselves are of no use, right? If we do not know how to make the use of these, okay? We have to make a good use of them for our progress. Students, it can be done only if people are hardworking, skilled and educated. Okay? They should have the knowledge and the skill to use the natural resources. To use the nature's resources. Okay? So students, the people of our country are the resources of India too. We can say the people of our country are called human resources. Okay, so students, what is human resources? The people of our country are called as human resources. They are the country's most valuable resources. Students, they should learn to utilize these resources effectively. Okay, only they can use if the people they have, they are educated, intelligent and skilled. Okay, so students, the skill and the efficiency of people of India make our human resources. Okay, students. Okay, students. Now, students, there are some reasons for India being underdeveloped. So, we'll learn what are the reasons why India is underdeveloped. So, students, our country is the second most populated country in the world. Okay, more than a billion of people live here. Okay, so students, the distribution of population in our country is very uneven. This means some areas are thickly populated, whereas some areas have very few people living in them. Okay, so students, do you know that more than half of total population of India live in 5 states? So we'll see. Which are the 5 states? That is Uttar Pradesh, Maharashtra, Bihar, West Bengal and Andhra Pradesh. Okay, students, Uttar Pradesh is the most populated state of India. Okay, and Sikkim, the least populated state in India. So students, India is a land of villages. Out of every 4 Indians, 3 live in villages. Okay, so students, there are the reason for uneven distribution. If we will talk about the distribution, the uneven distribution of population depends on a number of factors. So one of the most important factor is uneven distribution of natural resources and wealth. Okay, maximum population of our country reside in areas where there is abundance of natural resources like water, fertile soil, availability of medical facilities, job, educational facilities, housing, favorable climate, rainfall, fresh air, etc. Okay, so students, think of the region of India which have most of these. So students, for the past of many years, many people from village have been moving to cities in search of work. This movement is known as migration. Okay, so people, they shift from one place to another, they shift from one place to another for in search of job. Okay, the migrating people face many problems in cities, okay, such as finding shelter and job. Okay students, India ever increasing population has led many problems. A few of them are shortage of food and water, shortage of school and college in the country, illiteracy, increase in unemployment, increase in poverty. Students, this means that most of the people in the country earn less than their daily needs. They do not earn enough to fulfill their need. So this is the main reason for India is in the poverty line. And the main reason is ever increasing population. So students, the government. Okay students, I hope students you have understood about the reason for India being underdeveloped. Now students, in the next video we are going to learn about the steps taken by the government. By the time you have to read the textbook and underline the important.